Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and Claire Bay is joining us once again from Oriole Resources because more news from your company. You have completed the latest sampling program on your 90% owned central license package in Cameroon. So we're going to talk about that and much, much more. Maybe let's just kickstart with that. Tell us about this exploration update there in Cameroon.
Hi, Katie. Yep, as you say, this morning's update centred on our central license package project in central Cameroon. During the quarter, as discussed last week, the team's been continuing with a first-pass soil sampling programme. We reported the initial results for Grid 1 back in Q1, and that delivered a number of 2 to 3 kilometre anomalies in the Undom licence, and also this 11.5 kilometre anomalous zone at the Umbe licence, where we'd reported a best grade of a golden soil result of 838 parts per billion. Today, we've confirmed that the rest of the programme is now complete for a further 5 grids, and that includes Grid 6, which is a direct extension of that 11.5 kilometre zone at Umbe. The grids have now have completely focused on the anomalous stream sediment results that we identified last year, which appear to be related to the Chilero Banyo Shear Zone, which is a major structural corridor that extends for about 70 kilometres across the licence package, as well as the soil sampling. The team is now around 70% complete on a first pass mapping program at the Umbe anomaly. And we've also been undertaking a variety of technical studies on the geochemistry.
All right. And when can investors expect to see results from these programs then, Claire?
Very soon, I hope. We've collected just over 4,000 samples, and these are in the process of being prepped for dispatch. We've actually got samples for grids 2 and 4 that are already on their way to the laboratory. And so we're hoping to get the results later this quarter, possibly into early Q3. And then the rest of the sample batches will follow thereafter. And so we hope to have a steady stream of news flow as we go through Q3 and into the next field season. Okay. But it's not just gold where we're analysing, that we're analysing for. Multi-element analysis, as well as helping to identify other potential commodities that we may have within the CLP, also enables us to target the gold systems by finding geochemical associations, by targeting more mobile elements that are transported more easily in the soil. The results from the multi-elements that we had from Grid 1 have given us some useful pointers in that regard. Unfortunately, the turnaround time on multi-element analysis is very slow and it's quite expensive. So we've therefore borrowed a handheld XRF to undertake some comparative studies between what we're getting out of the lab and what we're getting in the XRF. It's a much cheaper analytical tool. So we're hopeful that we'll get a good correlation and we can look to purchase our own XRF going forward, and therefore reduce the cost and time of getting that further handle on what we've got overall in the CLP.
Mm-hmm. And Claire, you've also applied for an additional license at the central license package. Maybe tell us the rationale behind this.
Yes, we applied for the Mabauna license pretty much as soon as we'd identified that 11.5 kilometre anomaly at Umbe. Mm-hmm. Effectively, we've done it to maintain our competitive advantage in the area. We're already seeing a lot more exploration companies interested in Cameroon and staking licenses on the back of what we're doing, presumably, but also on the back of the mining ministry's drive to promote foreign investment. And so we wanted to make sure that we were able to do the CLP justice and test the full extent of the structures and anomalism that we've seen to date at Umbe and Undom. It's already showing live on the Cameroon Mining Cadastre. It's a first-come, first-served basis, so we're hopeful of a positive outcome. The footprint of the CLP as it stands is 3,592 square kilometres, and so if we are successful, this will push it up to more than 4,000 square kilometres as a single block, contiguous block. We have a number of images on our Twitter, LinkedIn website, which is orioleresources.com. So I'd encourage investors to go and take a look there. And we've also got a sign up page on our website for investors should they wish to follow the story on the CLP in a bit more detail.
All right, Claire, thank you very much indeed for your detail today here on Proactive London. That's Claire Bay from Oriole Resources.
Thanks, Katie.